like this. Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir. Very good afternoon to all of you. I'm here to share the initiative that ICT as an organization has undertaken to harness the potential of mobile and enable the public services to the citizens of the country. What I'm trying to pose to you here is, let's see, this is an ICT timeline chart. What ICT has grown over the span of 11 years, we have been pioneering the travel sector. We initially launched with a product, rail product, which is called the iTicket, which is the internet ticket, a physical ticket, which was delivered to your doorstep. Slowly, the iTicket has evolved now more to an e-ticket, which is the electronic ticket, जिसको आप ई टिकट भी कहते हैं. दिस टिकट इज बुक थ्रू द वेबसाइट एंड यू कैन टेक अ प्रिंट आउट ऑफ इट. नाउ इंस्टेड ऑफ टेकिंग अ प्रिंट आउट यू कैन ट्रैवल विद एन SMS also. सो स्लोली द वॉल्यूम्स ICTC बोस्ट ऑफ वॉल्यूम्स ऑफ बुकिंग ऑफ नियरली 5 lakh ट्रांजेक्शन अ डे एंड 1.5 lakh कैंसिलेशन अ डे. सो इट हैज ग्रोन फिनॉमिनली फॉर अस. This is just a small slide to show you what we do as of now for the Indian Railways. Nearly 55% of the tickets are booked through the window, that is a counter, and the 45% of tickets are booked through the online modes, that is our website, out of which I would say 8% are being booked through the agents and the 37% are being booked by our genuine customers. We try and enable our customers to book, come to us and directly book through our website. We have a whole lot of gamut of payment options, you name it, a payment gateway, the credit card, the net banking, the debit card, the cash card, they're all there. We do not try and integrate through a mode like an FSS. We try and do a direct integration with all our banks, with all our payment gateways. We have a whole lot of resource and a team which looks after all of this. Now, the question why we are all here today is, why does everybody want to go on mobile? We have been here since past 11 years on the online e-commerce. We are trying to deliver the solution to our end customers, to our agents. So we have soon realized that the growth of internet is a limitation. Not everybody in the country, in the masses, have access to internet. But mobile is something like, agar mujhe kisi ko kuch message dena hai, milna hai, I really don't need to physically go to a person. You know, so it's like mobile has replaced roads and modes of transport, which a lot of my colleagues here and presenters have presented today. So instead of going to a person physically, I can just maybe put in a message, just put in through a WhatsApp or whatever. So I certainly believe the same that why it should try and cater a solution through a mobile. What we have recently launched is an SMS-based booking, which I'll just tell you in a minute.
Shorter and faster.
Yes, sir. There are various stakeholders today in the mobile ecosystem. There's the telecom, there's the government, there's the media industry, there's the utilities, the equipment manufacturers. All of us together are working so that we deliver the solution to our end customers. How we plan to deliver the solution for our end customers is that we have tied up with various mobile operators and VAS providers like Airtel, Bharat BPO, Pyro, and Frequency Weekly. What we have done is we host our APIs. API is a set of bundle of functions which we expose to our companies. They are making the solutions for us. They are providing a solution in terms of SMS and a USSD. Airtel works on USSD mode. The other groups like Bharat BPO, Pyro, and Frequency Weekly are delivering the solution in the SMS. What we try to push to the end customer is that you book through mobile. Again, this is more of a technicality. What we are hosting is the APIs and the bundle of functions and the solutions we are giving to end customers. How we actually, again, if I talk to the ecosystem, there are mobile payments, there are user interactions, there's a user experience which is of prime importance, and there is again a social and a marketing and a medium by which we need to communicate to our end customers. Why we really want to proliferate the usage of SMS is like you can book through a mobile, book through an SMS, pay through an SMS, and travel through an SMS. So net, it's just you need to have a mobile connection with you. That's about it. With a certified telecom operator, you needn't have a high-end phone. You needn't have an internet connection, but you need to be registered for mobile payments. Now, mobile payments is something which we are again faltering today in the country. You know. We are working strongly with NPCI, the National Payment Corporation of India, to try and push the mobile payments in the country. It's an authorized RBI-approved organization. And I would strongly urge to the end customers and everyone in the country to try and use the IMPS modes of payment, which will further enhance this solution. Again, a few small KPIs, how actually a solution, irrespective of the mode of delivery to the customer, SMS, USSD, or mobile apps, these are certain KPIs, you know, it should be a fast service. There should be single sign-on for service. For us, it is the ICTC user ID. If you don't have ICTC user ID, then you can't book our booking. There's a mobile wallet. Airtel propagates his wallet. Telecom operators usually have their own wallet. Somebody may have their own Ola wallet, whatever. So it's one of the modes of payment again. Content acceleration, I think, in terms of USSD and SMS, which you're trying to deliver the customer, is not very essential. In terms of mobile apps, it is. And again, certain value adds, which, as I told you, it is purely book through SMS, travel through SMS. So it's total ease to the end customer as long as he knows how to do it. You know, one time when you do a booking, you can pre-save your SMS, the draft SMS. And you just need to change your from and to and date of journey and maybe name of passengers.
Can you please
wrap up? Yes, sorry.
Really, very, very clear.
Sorry, sir. And a few, again, the last few challenges that you're facing as of now. Again, as I said, NPCI is trying to drive to the country that it is a better mode of payment and a much cheaper mode of payment. So, which again, as we are also harping on the same fact. And again, as I said, connectivity is one of the issues. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.